obrigada por se encontrar com a gente.
Ah, minha porra foi distorcida.
A gente faz com que ninguém vai conhecer quem você é. Parte do que a gente está tentando fazer é encontrar e falar, conhecer algum desses madeireiros ilegais.
Lógico, Luí. Não, uma máfia envolve muita gente. E muita gente com poder.
Da corrupção?
Uhum. Muito.
Qualquer dessas cidades que a gente vai visitar mais pra dentro da Amazônia, mal a gente chega, eles vão saber que a gente está lá, né?
Sim. Rua sendo perigoso.
O que que acontece às pessoas que estão tentando parar desse?
Aqui morre. Aqui morre.
The Amazon rainforest is at a tipping point.
So all the little red dots, this is all...
more recent deforestation.
And criminal networks are pushing it closer to the edge. To understand how they operate, I'll travel to a violent frontier.
Nós encontrou duas covas. Tá vendo você morto.
What's fueling the multi-billion dollar trade for illegal timber? How's a global gold rush wreaking havoc on the jungle?
He said it could end up in a gold rain just like mine.
And what are the stakes for our planet?
I think it makes sense to think about the Amazon as a canary in the coal mine.
Watch out, watch out.
If we can't save it, we're doomed.
De sangue forte, Belém do Pará, Rio Major. Vim lá do norte trazer nosso carimbó. Então ponhamos na cintura.
500 miles from the mouth of the Amazon lies Itaituba, where a gold rush feeling hangs in the air.
So as soon as you get here, you get a sense that this whole town is geared towards exploiting the Amazon. You can see it everywhere. There's gold shops, there's places selling chainsaws, and even the local mayor is a former gold miner.
While it might not surprise you that illegal logging is a major factor in deforestation, gold mining is equally malicious. I've come to this region where nearly 30 tons of gold are extracted illegally every year as the first step on my mission to understand how criminal networks are decimating the Amazon.
Okay, we're here.
But how do I actually make my way into the Amazon's underworld? Through a contact, I've set up a meeting with a driver who works for local prospectors.
Obrigada por se encontrar aqui com a gente. Então me fala um pouco assim, como é que é a economia dessa região?
A economia de Itaituba depende do garimpo e da madeira.
Legal e ilegal, como é que é?
Poucos legal, mas é ilegal.
Seria fácil pra gente encontrar garimpo, que a gente pode filmar, garimpeiros, tudo isso?
Ilegal?
É.
Muito difícil. Eles não vão querer que filme.
Clearly, this is not the answer I'm looking for. But what I've learned from these situations is to never take the first no as the final answer.
Please.
And to keep buying drinks.
Para que a nossa mulher nunca fique viúva e nunca desculpe nossas namoradas.
Acordei e peguei no sono, desci a fantasia.
After a few rounds, the driver's tune has changed.
Tem galinha que vem dentro da mata, né?
He now says he might be able to get me into a mine he knows, deep in the Amazon jungle.
É.
But there's a catch.
Então eu acho pouco complicado.
Porque é bem dentro da floresta.
É isso. Não usa carro, não usa barco. Cara, só avião.
Então o único modo de chegar nesse garimpo é só de avião?
Só avião.
Perigoso mesmo chegar de avião,
né? É, tem umas pistas que são perigosas, são muito curtas.
E tudo isso, a pista, imagino, também é ilegal, né?
É, não é homologada, as pistas não são homologadas.
And so, thanks to my new drinking buddy, the next morning I find myself on one of the Amazon's infamous small planes.
Já teve problemas com o avião?
Muitos amigos nossos aqui já foram embora, morreram, caíram de avião.
É mesmo?
Já caí de avião. Olha, tá tranquila. Quem tá indicando é eu, né?
Que já caiu de avião.
É, já caiu, tem experiência.
Looking out the window, while trying not to think about going down in a ball of flames, I'm struck by the immensity of the Amazon. But in 2020, an area the size of 345 Manhattans was wiped out. And in Brazil, up to 94% of that deforestation can be considered illegal.
So all these brown dots that you see, all these clearings in the jungle, that's all the illegal gold mines.
So who are the criminals responsible for this destruction? And why is gold mining so devastating to the rainforest? I'm hoping to find out.
This is what it's like to land on a runway made out of dirt.
I can't tell you where I'm headed. It's an agreement I made last night with the driver.
So that's our guys waiting for us over there. They're our contacts who are taking us to the mine.
Guys, seriously, cameras down.
This is the area they asked not to film as we arrived.
But I can tell you this. It's always a little nerve-wracking getting in a car with a masked man. Someone I don't know if I can trust.
Você vai mudar sua voz, né?
Ah, a voz também vai ser mudada, prometo.
Esse garimpo aqui é ilegal.
Não é legal ainda.
Porque senão você não estaria usando máscara.
Com certeza.
The masked man, who I'll be calling Alain, says he's taking me to one of his four gold mines deep in the rainforest. Alain tells me that other illegal prospectors in the area know I'm here, and we need to be on guard.
They almost prevented us from even landing. And so he's saying that people are just super scared here.
In Brazil, illegal gold mining is estimated to bring in more than $1 billion a year. While gold trafficking is less widespread than logging, it can leave permanent scars. Loggers often harvest valuable trees and leave the rest. Miners, however, slash everything in their path.
Wow. Surrounded by the jungle here, it's just a big clearing right in the middle of the rainforest. This is pretty big, much bigger than I expected.
At the belly of a man-made crater, miners toil away in the mud, stripping back layer after layer of earth.
Duas máquinas, dois motores. Ele corta essa matéria aí todinha de cima, onde fica o cascalho, e a tubulação joga para a caixa, para concentrar o ouro.
It's a back-breaking, dirty job. Gold mines are a breeding ground for malaria, and the pace is furious.
It's crazy to think that all of this has been done in just 1 week. They just started working in this area a week ago, and you can see how much of it is already cleared out.
Deforestation from illegal gold mining has increased by more than 90% in recent years. And our insatiable thirst for the precious metal threatens to make the situation even worse. Tech companies consume hundreds of tons of gold a year. Pure gold is used in every smartphone.
Where are the products that are being produced in the Amazon going? They're coming here to the US, they're going to Europe. These massive corporations could decide to really trace the supply chains, but they're choosing not to.
The murky supply chain ensures that dirty gold finds its way into the market, much as blood diamonds do. And in Brazil, dirty gold has added significance.
Oh, it's mercury that they were putting in. Mas não tem perigo fazer isso, não?
Não. Perigo nenhum.
So he just has this mercury, and the gold sort of combines with the mercury, and that's how they look and find gold here.
Despite what Alain says, mercury leaves rivers poisoned. The pollution can spread hundreds of miles downstream.
You see these little specks? The yellow specks are the gold, and these little sort of silver balls? That's the gold covered in mercury.
Alain then takes the unrefined gold to a dealer, One who doesn't ask too many questions.
E você acha que esse ouro vai acabar no Brasil ou vai sair do Brasil para outro país?
Não sei para onde ele vai.
Pode acabar assim numa...
Uma aliança, num...
A gold ring just like mine. Em qualquer parte do mundo, né?
Com certeza, isso qualquer pessoa.
O que você fala para os críticos, para as pessoas que falam que vocês estão destruindo a Amazônia, cortando árvore, poluindo?
Todo mundo critica, se preocupa com assim, a Amazônia. Eu acho que eles teriam que pensar primeiro no país deles. Então, eu só tenho a dizer uma coisa, que eles deixam a gente trabalhar.
But if miners like Alain are simply left to their own devices, the Amazon will continue to face a dark future. And in many cases, they actually have very little to show for it.
Sometimes they only get 70 to 80 grams of gold out of an area like this, so all this work was almost for nothing.
That amount means only a few thousand dollars for a week of work for Alain and his two dozen workers.
Então é um pouco como jogar na lotaria, e jogar na lotaria da Amazônia.
Arriscar, querendo um prêmio melhor.
Traffickers in the Amazon are playing a high-stakes game. And more times than not, they're losing.
É uma falácia, uma mentira. Sabe dizer, ah, tá gerando renda.
Os que estão fazendo o desmatamento não são os que estão lucrando com isso.
Não, não são.
This man is an inside source from IBAMA, Brazil's Environmental Protection Agency.
Você acha que essa máfia está crescendo?
Bastante.
E o que é que pode acontecer a você se souberem que você está falando com a gente?
Acho um risco muito grande.
Porque podem fazer o quê?
Eles matam. A gente ainda é um eixo aqui.
Se tem esse risco, por que é que você está falando com a gente?
É importante que as pessoas saibam isso. Isso tudo continua acontecendo, está acontecendo mais do que nunca agora. E se ficar isso escondido, isso daí vai se perpetuar.
My source from IBAMA says that at the moment, his agency is losing the battle with the Amazon Mafia.
Como é que é possível isso continuar assim?
Isso continua porque é muito lucrativo. É muito lucrativo.
Então quem é que está lucrando com tudo isso?
A gente com poder político, com poder econômico. Tá, tem políticos envolvidos nisso.
And corruption in Brazil allows international criminal organizations to reap the benefits.
Quem financia isso ganha muito dinheiro e muitas vezes não está nem na Amazônia.
But getting black market commodities out of the country relies on one key player. The middleman.
Quanto do ouro que você que passa por aqui é legal?
50% legal e 50% ilegal.
This dealer buys gold from mines all over the Amazon basin. When he has enough, he melts it and sells it to international buyers.
Daqui sai tudo já legalizado ou passa a ser legalizado a algum ponto?
Daí para frente eu não sei como é que eles fazem para legalizar. Eu sei que vai, ele vai viajar legal.
Gold laundering, the mixing of legal and illegal gold, nearly ensures that trafficked gold finds its way into the market.
These massive corporations will turn a blind eye to the mixing of illegally obtained materials with legally obtained materials. And then they can take the certificate of authenticity for the legally obtained stuff and slap it on the whole batch and say, okay, we're good.
And because of this, 90% of Fortune 500 companies that invest in gold can be linked to illegal mines in Latin America.
E isso vale quanto agora em dólares, mais ou menos?
Aproximadamente uns 12.500 dólares.
Então tem pessoas acima de você que estão comprando esse ouro e essas são pessoas que estão fazendo muito mais dinheiro com ouro do que você, né?
Ah, sim, com certeza.
O que você acha das pessoas que falam que, através do teu trabalho, se está matando a Amazônia?
Não sei. Não sei te responder.
Se continuar explorando, que eventualmente a Amazônia, como a gente conhece agora, a floresta vai morrer.
Sim, com certeza. Tanto o garimpeiro, o madeireiro, todo mundo tem uma parcela de contribuição. Então, temos que procurar uma solução. Mas tomar uma medida radical de fechar o garimpo para que a Amazônia respire, vai salvar a Amazônia e matar o povo.
After seeing the effects of gold mining firsthand, I'm going deeper into the Amazon, hoping to find those responsible for deforestation's original sin.
The first step in deforestation in the Amazon is usually illegal logging. So there are a few types of wood in the Amazon that are really valuable on the international market, things like mahogany. Loggers will go in, they'll cut down those valuable trees, and then they will just chop down all the rest and then burn them. Then when the land is cleared from the fires, that can serve as cattle pastures.
Shockingly, an estimated 50% of logging in Brazil is illegal. And the United States is one of the biggest importers of trafficked wood from the Amazon.
Não existe uma ilegalidade isolada, então tá tudo associado.
The high stakes have made the jungle a violent place.
O cara que rouba madeira e manda matar, quem atrapalha ele?
On the edge of the Amazon's protected areas lies a small settlement.
Oi.
I've traveled here to understand what can happen to you when you go up against the Amazon Mafia.
Tudo cresce aqui, né?
É, tudo.
Watch me.
Osvalinda and Daniel Pereira run a small organic farm surrounded by old-growth timber. Nearly all the forests adjoining their property have been cut down in recent years.
Sair da vossa propriedade e ver tudo morto, tudo desmatado.
Desastre, né? E a madeira tá toda aqui, né? São madeira não sei nem de quantos anos, acho que desde o começo do mundo, né?
The Pereiras have managed to protect and plant new trees on their farm, and they've reported illegal activity to the authorities, which has made them a target of local criminals.
São cinco grupos de madeireiro que se agia aqui dentro.
Então toda a floresta que foi retirada à volta aqui é tudo ilegal.
Ilegal.
Ilegal, ilegal mesmo.
One day, after returning to their house, the couple found a local logging boss waiting for them, accompanied by a squad of armed men.
Ele falou, deu minha cara assim, olha, com esse trabalho seu, você vai morrer que nem a Dorothy.
Brazil has about 30% of the world's biodiversity. And so can you imagine when somebody chops down a tremendous area that burns for 10 days?
Dorothy Stang was an American nun who campaigned for 30 years to stop illegal loggers in the Amazon. In 2005, while walking in the jungle, she was murdered with six shots fired at close range. Stang's murder is far from an isolated incident. More than 1,700 people have been killed in land conflicts since 2000. And in this part of the world, where impunity reigns, only 10% of the murders were brought to justice. Following the threats from the local logging boss, the Pereiras awoke one morning to find that someone had crept onto their farm.
Posso ver?
Sim, pode.
Leaving a terrifying warning.
Com cruzes e tudo, hein?
As covas mostravam que era o fim da gente, sabe? Que não era só boato, não era só a pessoa vir, já era você, tá vendo você morto. E o que não passou, não desejo pra ninguém.
The Pereiras continue to receive death threats, but they refuse to let the criminals have their way.
Foi não, Daniel. A nossa luta não pode terminar agora. Nós não estamos nessas covas aí. Nós estamos vivos. E nós vamos lutar.
Por isso que vocês dizem que se é para morrer, é para morrer aqui, né?
Para morrer aqui.
Vocês Você trabalha para o IBAMA. A IBAMA é a agência que deveria estar parando essas madeireiras ilegais, esse desmatamento da Amazônia. Por que é que vocês não estão fazendo mais?
A gente não consegue. Por causa da quantidade de pessoal que diminuiu, pelo menos da metade, o IBAMA está sendo desmontado por dentro.
My source says the situation got even more dire after the 2018 election of Brazil's president, Jair Bolsonaro.
É uma falácia dizer.
It is a fallacy that the Amazon is a heritage of humanity, and it is also a mistake to say it is the lungs of the world. Certain countries are using these fallacies, and instead of helping, have started to attack with lies.
When Jair Bolsonaro was elected, a lot changed. Deforestation skyrocketed. There's been a massive rollback in respect for indigenous rights, and Bolsonaro has regularly in public encouraged Amazon deforestation. He's encouraged the arsonists lighting a lot of the fires, and he's defamed a lot of the indigenous leaders. When the head of state is encouraging violence, that sends a very clear message.
According to observers, his administration has effectively given a green light to those who want to destroy the Amazon for profit, which critics say includes the most powerful man in Itaituba. At his Riverside mansion, I arrange a meeting with the town's mayor, Valmir Clímaco.
Eu sou a Mariana.
Tudo bem?
Obrigada por receber a gente.
He's not shy about his past as a logger and miner. According to Clímaco's own election filings, he's the subject of 45 federal criminal citations. But his trouble with the law hasn't hurt his popularity.
Fui o candidato, o prefeito mais bem votado do estado do Pará, com quase 80% dos votos.
Mayor Clímaco now owns cattle ranches and farms cleared from the rainforest, industries responsible for millions of acres of deforestation.
Tem muita gente que olha para o senhor, que vê um exemplo de uma pessoa que está fazendo essa exploração da Amazônia.
Sou um homem, vamos dizer assim, muito trabalhador. E quem é trabalhador que cresce, geralmente o povo inventa uma história. Jesus Cristo, quando na Terra, até tinha seus críticos.
É verdade que o senhor foi condenado?
Fui condenado e fui absolvido. Se eu não pudesse, eu não podia ser prefeito. Mas claro que eu estou atrás da minha sobrevivência. Mas um trabalho legal.
Clímaco was acquitted of some charges, though he still faces pending trials for alleged environmental crimes dating back to 2012. However, Clímaco doesn't think mining and logging are hurting the Amazon either way.
Quem dizer que garimpeiro acaba com a Amazônia não tem conhecimento igual eu tenho. Porque garimpo não mata, não. Você passa em cima de avião, você não vê onde trabalharem. Não é o garimpeiro, não é o madeireiro.
In the Amazon, this is all a seductive argument for those who stand to make huge profits. But it doesn't mesh with the reality I've seen in my time here.
Questão do mercúrio. Já foram estudos feitos, provaram que existe um índice muito elevado de mercúrio no rio Tapajós.
Eu desafio que alguém, que algum médico já deu um atestado aqui de um paciente que dizer que morreu de azul. Eu já pesei mais de meia tonelada de ouro. Queimei, tocou a fogo. Não usava máscara, não usava nada. Nunca senti uma dor na unha.
Rather than debating the mayor on the merits of inhaling mercury fumes, I want to ask him about the slew of killings in the region, including Dorothy Stang, the American nun.
Tem muita gente que estão tentando preservar a Amazônia sendo mortos. O que é que você acha disso?
Vou só contra as pessoas que mandaram matar. Nós não podemos hoje ser uma freira e estar com um bocado de gente o dia todo indo no meio da rua querendo invadir o que é dos outros.
With the help of the FBI, Brazilian authorities eventually convicted two ranchers of orchestrating Dorothy Stang's murder.
Então você acha que aqueles que estão sendo mortos porque estão invadindo, estão entrando?
Não, ele não é que estão invadindo, ele vem incentivar, ele vem arrumar confusão.
Clímaco's own property lies alongside the ancestral territory of the Munduruku indigenous tribe. For Clímaco, letting them manage the land would be the real travesty.
E na hora que abre a possibilidade do índio mexer com garimpo, índio não tem dinheiro para comprar maquinário, índio não tem coragem de trabalhar.
Clímaco Despite what Mayor Climaco says, Brazil's indigenous people are now some of the most courageous defenders of the Amazon. Still on the search for illegal loggers, I'm going on patrol with members of the Munduruku indigenous tribe.
We've been going in further and further in for over an hour now. They're actually looking for signs that there's been illegal activity in this area.
I'm on patrol with the Munduruku tribe, trying to catch illegal loggers in the act.
All these cut branches that you see are clear signs that there's been some sort of illegal activity. Usually it's illegal loggers that come here and start cutting the branches so they can go through deeper into the jungle. Look, aqui, aqui. This is all evidence that the illegal logger has been here. You can see a whole structure over there.
This camp has been set up in the short time since the Munduruku last went on patrol.
É perigoso esse trabalho de fiscalização.
Aí a gente fica muito visto pelos pessoal, tanto madeireiro, garimpeiro.
Chief Juarez plans to confront the loggers and force them out of Munduruku territory.
Então, e mesmo quando a gente está indo, vocês já sabem que já tem pessoas trabalhando lá, o senhor fica nervoso?
Eu só vou deixar de lutar depois que eu não tiver conseguido mais andar.
It's a bullet case, 38 cal. Eles estão muitas vezes...
Não, agora é direto.
Tem arma
pesado eles.
É muito perigoso.
Brazil's indigenous people have increasingly come under violent attack.
Garimpeiros atacaram a aldeia indígena na fazenda Tapajós. O local é residência de uma das principais lideranças da etnia Munduruku.
Um confronto entre garimpeiros ilegais e indígenas deixou pelo menos 5 feridos.
Garimpeiros portando armas de fogo em 7 barcos atiraram contra indígenas.
Even with the chance of an armed encounter, Chief Juarez says it's time to move forward.
They've heard that there's people actually cutting down trees about an hour from here. So he says we should keep going. We'll try to go as far as we can.
As we proceed deeper and deeper into the rainforest, it's hard not to feel completely exposed. Criminals could be behind any bend of the river. After another hour on the water, the chief stops our boat. The loggers have clearly been here.
Então essa ave para nós, ela é uma ave sagrada.
They came in with chainsaws to look for trees like this, and they left it behind because they realized it was actually going to fall into the river.
Não é só nós que tem que ver isso. O mundo tem que olhar para isso. É a nossa Amazônia. É por isso que a gente tem que cuidar.
Even with fresh evidence of their work, the chief says the criminals have slipped away. But 2 days later, I get a new lead. After dozens of calls, I finally receive a promising message from a local contact. And a former illegal logger.
O chefe da operação vai encontrar vocês lá em estrada de acesso. Vocês não têm autorização nenhuma de mostrar onde é o local exato das filmagens, tá?
It's the access I've been working on for months. But it's in an area with one of Brazil's highest murder rates. I'll be miles and miles from help if anything goes wrong. And as I head out to an undisclosed location, I have no idea what or who I might find.
Okay, this is it. Okay.
Running, guys.
Wait!
Let's do it.
The boss meets me at the access road and says we need to hurry onto the truck so we're not spotted.
Okay, so we go in the back of the truck.
It's not an accident that this is a bumpy run. Loggers cut narrow roads hidden under the forest canopy to throw off aerial surveillance.
We just got stuck. The big truck got stuck. I have no idea how they plan on picking it out of here.
The truck isn't going anywhere. And on top of that, we're suddenly alone.
The guy who's taking us in just left. So we're stuck here. It's super muddy and wet everywhere.
Stranded in the middle of the jungle, with potentially violent criminals operating in the area. And there's nothing to do but wait.
So we're stuck here. Just us and a big illegal logging truck.
After 30 minutes, our contact returns. And he's got some heavy equipment with him. The rainy season is normally a quiet time of the year for the illegal timber trade because of the difficulty reaching the jungle. But these loggers seem to be working harder than ever.
But I mean, it's incredible. It's just in the middle of this thick, thick piece of jungle, and there's just this clearing. And this is what they've done. They've just cleared this all out.
The loggers tell me that just yesterday, a member of another crew was killed during the part of the process I'm watching now.
They're saying it's incredibly dangerous to be behind where the log is going up because it's common that the cables break and it will fall on, so a lot of people have been injured and killed when this happens. They're just these, like, two cables that are pulling the log up to the truck. This is all super sketchy. I mean, they're barefoot, you know? They're doing all of this. A lot of them are barefoot.
It may not be a high-tech operation, but they work fast and efficiently.
So they've done all of this damage that you see here, all this clearing in just the last 2 weeks. E quantas árvores vocês vão cortar hoje?
Elas cortam umas 10, 15 árvores.
E tudo isso é ilegal?
É ilegal.
E o que aconteceria a vocês se soubessem que vocês estariam fazendo isso?
Nós ia preso.
Vocês têm mais medo de quem? Da polícia? Do Ibama? Quem é que vocês têm mais medo?
Do Ibama. Polícia não. Polícia não tem medo, não.
Por quê?
Fala o dinheiro, né? Eles deixam liberado aí.
Loggers usually take pains to avoid being caught. Ibama raids mean crippling fines and destroyed equipment. But insiders say the illegal timber trade is operating more openly than in years past.
They say they're going to cut down another tree right now.
The men tell me how they clear the most valuable trees first and are quick to spot which ones to cut next.
Yeah, so they're saying that they think it's going to fall that way, but when it does, when it cracks, that a lot of sort of debris, oh my God. Did you hear that? So that's it. When you hear that first crack, that means the tree is falling. It's slowly falling. And then you just... Pra onde? Watch out. Vai pra lá. Wow. I mean, it's insane. You can feel hear the cracks incredibly loud. And then you can feel the whole sort of ground shake.
Knowing that these trees could soon end up in a wood floor or backyard deck somewhere in the U.S., it's hard to stomach.
Posso ver? Okay, let's go see the. He's saying we can go and see it, the fallen tree. Uau! Não vale muito, não? Porque tá oco, é?
Não presta.
Não presta pra nada? É mesmo? Vocês não podem utilizar isso? Pra nada? Não usam isso pra nada?
Não dá nada, não é ferrado.
Não dá nada. Olha. It's not even worth anything, which makes this whole thing even more depressing. I mean, all of this wasted for nothing.
Seeing this pointless destruction reminds me of what I witnessed at the gold mine. The Amazon is being ravaged based on false hopes by those in the trenches.
Então toda a tua vida tem sido
toda a minha vida. Se fechar a madeira, nós vamos passar fome. Nós não sabemos fazer outra coisa e não tem outro meio de vida.
If there's one thing I've learned from reporting on the world's black markets, it's that the people who are getting their hands dirty often feel like they have no other choice. Criminals on the bottom rung of the shadow economy say they're simply trying to survive.
Antes da gente vir, nos avisaram, cuidado, essa gente é perigosa. Já houve ativistas que morreram, que foram mortos, assassinados.
Não, aqui a gente não é assim não, a gente aqui tá do bem, né?
Então quem é que tá matando? Quem são essas pessoas?
É clérigo, é gente grande por trás, né, que paga eles para fazer isso.
Holding those accountable for the murders in the Amazon is seemingly an impossible task. It's no surprise that so many of those killings have gone unpunished. I may never come face to face with those at the top, but I have one last way to expose the Amazon Mafia. I'm going to follow the timber. Under the cover of night, the logs I saw being cut down in the Amazon earlier are transported here to this illegal sawmill. I still want to understand what happens to timber illegally harvested in the Amazon, and if this wood will soon end up in the hands of U.S. consumers.
É isso, mas tem que botar microfone, senão a gente não escuta.
But nobody at the mill wants to talk.
E daqui tá indo para onde?
A madeira?
Sim.
Não, daí eu não sei. Eu trabalho aqui.
E você sabe se essa serraria se é trabalho legal ou ilegal?
Não sei. Eu não dizer se é trabalho legal ou ilegal, não.
Então por que você está usando máscara?
É porque é melhor não usar.
Suddenly, I'm told it's time for us to stop filming. A shipment of cut boards is heading out, and we've been explicitly warned not to follow. It's frustrating to leave without tracking this wood any farther, but I already know where a lot of it is headed.
Sometimes it's a bit of a reveal. When you look at a shipment like this and you open it up, it takes your breath away for a second. To be like, wow, that's not what I was expecting. And you realize how big some of the wood is. You do step back and you put that in perspective. How old was that tree?
At a warehouse near the port of Houston, agents from U.S. Customs and Border Protection are inspecting a new shipment from Latin America.
Some of the wood today is raising red flags. When we look at the documents, the wood states that it's a certain age. When we come here and physically look at the wood, it looks much older than what's on the documents. Therefore, it probably didn't come from the mill. It's on the paperwork, and then we're gonna look further into that wood.
As one of the largest timber importers in the world, the U.S. is a prime target for black market organizations. But smuggling trees from the Amazon is a federal crime, in violation of the Lacey Act.
We attempt to catch everything that comes our way. Due to the pure volume of stuff like that, most likely stuff does make it through, but our attempt is to catch everything entering this country.
One estimate now puts the worldwide trade for illegal timber as high as $152 billion.
We are seeing a larger increase in shipments coming out of the Amazon than previous years. So the problem isn't going away. Only increasing.
Você acha que os consumidores na Europa e nos Estados Unidos sabem que as madeiras que eles estão utilizando são ilegal?
Eu acho que alguém deve desconfiar disso.
There's so much responsibility that we have to address our own contributions to the climate crisis. So many of the companies that are based here are buying and selling the very products that are produced in deforested parts of the rainforest. It comes down to how important is it and how important are we insisting that it be. I think it makes sense to think about the Amazon as a canary in the coal mine, in the sense that if we can't save it, we're doomed.
All these little red dots that are a lot of them, all represent deforestation that has happened in just the last 5 years.
Exactly. 20% of the Amazon rainforest is already deforested. Mm-hmm. So we reached that level. If we keep deforesting, we may reach a tipping point.
So the death of the Amazon as we know it?
Yes, that's a possible scenario.
Carlos Souza is a researcher for an environmental nonprofit called Amazon. Through satellite technology, they're able to monitor deforestation on a micro level, including the illegal logging site I witnessed myself.
It's crazy to think that it looked so massive at the time, and now to think that it's just probably a little tiny, tiny, tiny little dot.
That's why it's so important to have a near real-time forest monitoring.
Right.
Because you can see the most active mm-hmm. areas and go
stop it.
To stop it vertically. But we have
the data is alarming. Dr. Souza says it should be a wake-up call for the entire world.
So does that mean that this is it? It's completely hopeless? There's nothing we can do about it?
There is hope. First, we have to make sure that they're not purchasing anything from the Amazon that's linked to illegal deforestation. And then we need more international awareness about the problem to convince Brazil to change this path mm-hmm. to destruction.
The good news is that it's not too late. And there are still those on the ground fighting against deforestation. Looking at the Amazon from high above, it's striking that there are these islands of intact forest. When you get closer, you notice that many of those areas are indigenous lands. Before leaving the Amazon, I returned to one of those islands, the Munduruku territory. I reunite with tribal leader and activist, Alessandra Munduruku. Tonight, the village is having a meeting to discuss how they can fight back against a new bill proposed by the Bolsonaro government. The bill would open up mining in protected areas like the Munduruku territory.
A gente não vai sair do lugar onde nós nascemos, nós temos crianças, nossos filhos, nosso antepassado sempre viveu aqui. O governo brasileiro não tem direito de nos matar. Ele não tem direito.
The Amazon's hundreds of indigenous tribes have survived conquest, smallpox, enslavement, and assimilation. And the future of our planet might depend on them standing in the way of the Amazon Mafia.
Será que é tão difícil as pessoas entender que nós queremos vida, queremos água, queremos floresta, queremos nossas crianças livres? As nossas crianças estão brincando embaixo da chuva. Elas brincam embaixo da chuva, elas brincam no seu terreno, elas brincam na sua casa. A única coisa que nós fazemos é defender a nossa casa. É aqui que nós vamos ficar, é aqui que nós vamos morrer. É aqui a nossa casa.
But for the Munduruku, stopping powerful criminal networks alone is too much to ask. Foreign governments will have to supply pressure. And consumers will have to investigate where the products they buy come from. And if we are helping to protect the Amazon, we'll destroy it.